Hi, I'm Pandu and I would like to show you in this video how you could get 30 settlers to your Fallout 4 settlement. The reason for this is that a lot of Fallout 4 pages are saying you need 30 settlers to get the level 4 vendor Smiling Larry to your settlement. So at first you have to know that every settlement has a base value of 10 settlers. Every additional settler requires 1 point of charisma from your character, which results in that your character has to have 20 charisma. And by that I mean a permanent value. You can't rely on any chems like Mentats or something like that. The easiest way, of course, would be to just open the command console and type in the right command to increase your charisma. Like player set AV charisma 20. And believe me, that would be a lot more easier than the only way I figured out so far. But before we get to that, I would like to show you something else. This may be a bug, so I don't entirely sure if it works on every system and with every version of Fallout 4. There's a place called Starlight Drive-In where you have to install a propaganda tower, or what is called, for the Minuteman quest. And if you leave the place totally unattended after you install the tower, the settlers will increase to more than your actual charisma value. But now to the real and only solution I figured out so far. First step. You need a character with a base value of 10 charisma. It doesn't matter if you create a character with this value or you get the charisma points from the occasional level ups. Then you get back to your house and pick up the You Are Special magazine from your child's bedroom. As you can see, the system doesn't allow you to choose another charisma point because it thinks you already have the maximum. So you need a little trick to get this to work. You have to use a Daddy-O before you pick up the magazine itself. If you need a guaranteed location to find a Daddy-O, just travel to the South Boston police station and get to the toilet on the bottom floor. Then use the Daddy-O before you pick up the magazine, choose the charisma attribute and wait a few minutes till the Daddy-O runs out. Your Pip-Boy should show you at this point that you have 11 charisma. Third step, you get the charisma bubblehead from the Parsons State Asylum. This is actually a very large quest which I couldn't explain in this video, but you will find a lot of guides to get in there. At this point you shouldn't have any problems getting the 12th charisma point. You just have to pick up the figurine and your Pip-Boy should show you that you have 12 charisma points now. So all you need now are 8 additional charisma points, which brings me to our next step. The clothing. You need at least 3 pieces of clothing to get 4 points of charisma. I would suggest you get to the highest floor of the Hubris Comics building in the heart of Boston and take the glasses and the wig from the shelf there. Each of these items gives you 1 additional point of charisma. Next, you need a pair of summer shorts. You can find one of those at the General Atomics Galleria on the north side of the map. Just steal them from the counter or do the little quest inside the Galleria to get them from the robots. Which brings me to the 5th and last step. The summer shorts will give you 2 points of charisma and only replace 1 piece of armor. Which means you can still wear arm and leg armor. Which brings us to the tricky and most time intensive part of this quest. You have to get 4 pieces of armor with a sharp attribute. Because sharp means that the piece of armor has 1 point of charisma and 1 point of intelligence. So now you have to farm a lot of super mutants and other enemies to get 4 different pieces of armor with 1 point of charisma. And if you manage that, after hours or days of trying, you finally got 20 charisma. I hope you got the gist of it. I'm obviously not a native English speaker, but if it helped you, please give this video a like. Thank you.